Hello, and welcome to the series on the multiphysics analysis of a car headlamp in Simcenter 3D. In the previous video, we saw how to work with an assembly FEM and create a 3D mesh of a component. In this video, we will show how to create a surface wrap mesh for the air volume within the headlamp. Using the existing assembly geometries, a surface wrap mesh for the air volume can be automatically created, which will later be used in this coupled thermal flow structural analysis. We can start by hiding the mesh and only displaying the geometries. We then need to define a surface wrap recipe. By selecting all bodies as the surface wrap boundaries, we can then detect any cavities within the assembly and select the cavity where we'd like to apply the surface wrap mesh for the air volume. Here we can also define element type and size, as well as several other meshing options for the air volume surface. We can now see the new surface wrap recipe has been added to the tree of the assembly FEM file. Now that we see the feature edges of the surface wrap recipe, we can see it is a little bit too coarse for what we want, and will therefore reduce the mesh size and update the surface wrap. Now that we have an adequate surface mesh defined for the air volume, we can now mesh the air volume with 3D elements using a 3D hybrid mesh from shell elements. This type of mesh will allow a tet mesh near the walls where geometries are more complex, and a hex mesh on the interior mesh which will allow for a more robust calculation. From the options, we can also select the number of element layers at the wall to be trimmed from the hex mesh, which may need to change based on element size and complexity of geometry. We can now see a new mesh collector for the fluid volume has been created, and can modify the display to make it easier to see. The mesh can be inspected using clip sections to ensure the transition from tet to hex mesh and mesh size are adequate. In this video, we saw how to create a surface wrap mesh from existing geometries for the air volume using a hybrid 3D mesh with tetrahedral elements on the surfaces and a hexahedral mesh on the interior nodes. In the next video, we will move on to the simulation environment of Simcenter 3D and apply some boundary conditions to the model.